of times we don't mind answering to man, but we don't want to answer to God. A lot of times we don't mind being faithful to man, but we fail to be faithful to God. What we understand, realize, you can get out there and break the speed limit, violate the speed limit, and get a ticket like my daughter-in-law did. Oh yeah, I'm going to tell on her tonight. And then you got to pay the ticket. But that's not the highest authority. That's not the end of the thing. The highest authority that we got to answer to is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm going to help you with this tonight. I'm going to get you to the place where when you wake up in the morning, you're going to be thinking about Jesus. See, he that got the Son got both the Father and the Son. But he that had not the Son had neither the Father nor the Son. That's why the Bible said when Thomas saw Jesus, Thomas fell down and said, "My Lord and my God." See, Jesus got to be more than just your Lord. He got to be your God. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing the other night. As a matter of fact, Philip said, "Show me the Father and it suffices me." Philip said, "You just show me who the Father is, I'll be satisfied." And Jesus said, "Have I been so long with you, Philip, and you don't know who I am?" He said, "When you've seen me, you've seen the Father." Good God all day. If you want to know God, know the Father. But if you're going to see him, you got to see the Son. But if you want to have an experience with him, you got to get the Holy Ghost. Because these three ain't but one. Clap your hands and give him praise like that. So Obadiah said he's our highest authority. But Jonah picked this thing up, and Jonah said that God's mercy. Jonah could tell you about some mercy, because Jonah found himself in a mess. He found himself, I'm talking about running from God, trying to hide from God. I'm not afraid that some of y'all out there tonight are hiding from God. But I want you to understand all the stuff that you did. If it had not been for God's mercy, you would not be here tonight. You would have been stepped out. But thank God for mercy, because mercy kept you, to grace stepped in and delivered you, and that's the reason why you ought to be excited tonight, because God is a merciful God, because God is a kind God, because God is a loving God. But there is another side to God. I don't want to talk about that tonight. I want to talk about God's mercy, because that's what Jonah was talking about. How many of y'all know tonight, if God would have held the stuff against us, what we did, we would have been on our way to hell. But the thing I like about God, God looked beyond all of our faults, and God saved us anyway. That was never mercy. You tonight, but can I talk about me for a little while? I was tore up from the floor, I was a mess. If God would have not stepped in on time, ain't no telling where I would be, ain't no telling what I would be involved in. But when I thank God all day about God's mercy, I get excited because I know that if it were not for God's mercy, look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor tonight. Say, "I think the preacher preaching to you tonight." Say, "You know that God showed you mercy." Say, "I can look at you and see you were tore from the floor." Say, "You were nothing but a hot mess." Say, "God showed you mercy." Say, "If God wouldn't have showed you mercy, you wouldn't be on this seat sitting with me tonight." Say, "Give God the praise for his mercy." The thing I like about God shows some of us a lot of mercy. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing there. But when I look in the book of Micah, the Bible says that he is the messenger of the gospel. And the book of Nahum, the Bible says he's the avenger of God's elect. I want to talk about that a little while, because the Bible says unto us, we don't have no need to fight our battles, because if you belong to God, God will fight every one of your battles. The Bible said there is no weapon. I say that all the time. The reason why I say it all the time, because God can't go against his word. And so as long as I let that word flow out of my mouth, that there is no weapon that's formed against me to be able to prosper. And every tongue that rises up against me in judgment, I got the power to condemn it. God said, "I put something inside of you, but you got to open your mouth and let it out." And I don't have to fight. I don't have to fight. Why? Because God don't fight my battles. I know the Bible says they may come against you one way, but God declared they'll flee seven different ways. I come to tell you today, when you got King Jesus on your side, you don't have to be fighting your battles, because he'll step in right on time. He'll fight every one of your battles. Clap your hands. praise and give him praise. So now, as we begin to look, in the book of Habakkuk. Habakkuk say he was a rock hewed out of the side of a mountain. Habakkuk say he was our firm foundation. But Zephaniah picked this thing up. And Zephaniah say with the precipice and the glory of Israel. And Haggai picked it up, and Haggai said he will restore of God's lost heritage. And then Zechariah picked it up. And Zechariah said he's a merciful father. And Malachi picked it up. And Malachi said he's our glorious promise. But it did not stop there. There 400 years, there was no news from heaven. 400 years, could nobody hear from God. 400 years, people were seeking God. And there was a famine in the land. It wasn't a famine for water. It wasn't a famine for food. It was a famine for the word of God. But after 400 years, the Bible said the Lord have mercy. Can I take my time and deal with that tonight? Because we're about to make a transition here. Now we're getting ready to go from the old to the new. Because in the Old Testament, there were Lord have mercy. God began to deal with the prophet. But in the New Testament, the last Old Testament prophet was John the Baptist. I know you thought he was a New Testament prophet. But John the Baptist was the last of the Old Testament prophet. He was the one that bridged the gap between the old and the new. And so what God did, God said, I need a man that can be bold. I need a man that can stand tall. I need a man that can be firm. I need a man that not gonna be a wimp. So what God did, God filled John the Baptist with the Holy Ghost. I come up before he come out of his mother womb. John was the only individual that you read of in the scriptures. He came here with the Holy Ghost. But y'all ain't saying nothing there. And so John wanted to let us know that there's somebody coming after me. And he coming, he gonna baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. I don't know about y'all tonight, but I thank God for the Holy Ghost. Shake your neighbor, say neighbor. Say y'all to thank God for the Holy Ghost. Say but every now and then, you ought to feel the fire. As they begin to cross over in the book of Matthew, Matthew said that he was the king of the Jews. Mark picked the thing up, and Mark said he was the son of God, and he was a wonder worker. And then Luke picked it up, and Luke said that he was the son of man. Now this is important, because a lot of people get confused. They get confused between humanity and deity. See, according to the flesh, he was the son of a man, meaning they were born of a woman. But according to deity, he was the son of God. That's simply saying that God, when God looked in heaven, God looked in earth, and God couldn't find nobody that was worthy to come and die for the people. So what did God do? He stepped off his throne. He stepped off out of his law and mercy, down to 42 generations. He paid law and mercy. He stepped into the belly of Mary, stayed there for 9 months, stepped out of Mary's belly, got God all day. After 12 years, he said, now it's time that I'll be about my father's business. Stayed here for 33 and a half years. After 30 years, he started his priesthood. Because in the Old Testament, you could not be a priest till you made 30 years old. So when Jesus made 30 years old, Jesus said, now is my time. He said, now is my hour. Good God all day. But Jesus said, wait a minute. As long as I'm here in the flesh, I can't be in one place at one time. He said, but now I'm getting ready to go back to heaven. He said, but I'm not going to leave your confidence. He said, well, send back another comforter. In the original text, he was saying, I'm going away in one form, but I'm coming back in another form. And that's the thing people can't understand. How in the world that Jesus could be 100% man and don't stop being God? That's how bad he is. That's how awesome God is. That's how strong God is. That's how powerful God is. Y'all better catch it today. And so Jesus said, when I send back the Holy Ghost, he coming back in my name. Aren't y'all